I saw a recent lecture by a famous psychologist. She was talking about the relationship between online dating and the massive dumpster fire the modern dating game has turned into. She said that at its core, it's all about false signals. Compared to a more organic system where the only signals of attraction you get and send are the ones you get and send to people in your physically local social circle. These would be much more accurate and they would create a much more realistic and calibrated measure of your sexual value as perceived by others. This would also create a much more realistic and much more closely calibrated to reality idea of any opportunity costs. One thing that ants and bees have in common, as do all you social groups, is different classes do different things. Worker ants and worker bees never get laid. They are born only to work to support the queen. There's a theory that the common problem of cute girls and their orbiters doesn't really represent a breakdown in society, rather a re-emergence of our ancient mating instincts. That this idea of many men competing for the sexual attention of one female is more natural and much more deeply embedded into our genetics than anybody would like to admit. One of the interpretations of the four horsemen of the apocalypse is the things that always happen to a collapsing society: pestilence, war, famine, and death. Every time any ancient society lost the ability to grow enough food to feed everybody, coupled with the inevitable corruption that is found in many late-stage societies, these four things would tend to show up. So it's possible that the author of the Book of Revelation was using his knowledge of history to motivate the then Christians being heavily oppressed by the corrupt Roman rulers to hang in there. Which is the same message Jesus shared, that the corrupt will get their due and the meek but holy will get their reward. Of course, this is one response to a very similar reason for the creation of any religion: to try and answer the question of why there is so much suffering in the world, and why the vicious tend to enjoy much more worldly success than the meek, who tend to be much less vicious. In plenty of cultures, both modern and old, boys are preferred babies. And in plenty of cultures, both modern and ancient, when the number of babies are limited, either by the environment or by decree, female babies are killed in order to have baby boys. This leads to a very common situation of many boys but few girls. And in ancient hunter-gatherer societies, this would mean that many men competing for one or few girls could only compete via productivity or hunting, with the best hunters getting the girl and making the babies, and the average hunters only really having two choices: keep hunting and maybe one day be a good enough hunter to get laid, or to stop hunting and get kicked out of the tribe, which would mean certain death. Academics are extremely reluctant to consider humans as being eusocial, as that might lead to accepting that having a class of workers or slaves is defensible according to biology, which means academics don't like pursuing ideas not because they might not be true, but because of the implications if they are true. In an older, more organic society, people would tend to have an accurate idea of the costs and benefits with respect to relationships. This would make relationships much stronger and longer lasting. But now with social media, we all get plenty of false signals, a false sense of opportunity cost, and a subsequent unrealistic idea of our own value. Men seem to believe through social media that there are attractive women in abundance, but their day-to-day experience contradicts this. Women seem to believe through social media that they are much more desirable than they really are, but their day-to-day experience contradicts this. Anytime any system has a decoupling of benefits and the associated costs, both direct costs and opportunity costs, within a natural feedback system, it no longer becomes self-sustaining. Sometimes, however, these systems can exist, powered only by inertia, much longer than anybody can predict.